Hey there, Geoff Manchester from iZotope. iZotope Ozone Pro is one of the most popular and powerful mastering tools available. It's been around for about 20 years. But even if you're brand new to the plugin or you've been using it for those 20 years, I guarantee you there's features that you don't even know about. And that's what this video is about. I want to showcase 10 lesser known features that might help to speed up your workflow or just give you an edge the next time you're producing. But before we get started, please make sure to subscribe to this YouTube channel and hit that little bell icon to be notified the next time a new video becomes available. Let's get started. Ozone Pro has a powerful undo history module that allows you to go back in time if you don't like your settings. But what some people don't realize is that there's a powerful compare feature called set. In this section, you can assign up to 4 points in the history lists to sets A, B, C, or D. This is useful for comparing different settings at once. For example, if we wanted to quickly audition 4 different IRCs, or intelligent release controls, in Ozone's maximizer, without having to scroll through the drop-down menus to toggle them, just click on the ones you want to audition to make them appear in the undo history window, then assign each one to a letter. Now, you can use your ears to see which IRC is right for you. And this is just the tip of the iceberg. You can also toggle clusters of processing and complex chains against each other too. The Imager module in Ozone Pro is one of the most popular modules in the tool. It's helpful for making your track sound wide and panoramic, but did you know? You also have a free phase correlation meter with 4 different views to make sure that your mix is going to translate to a mono playback device. Even without any widening processing employed by the module, you'll see the correlation meter light up when audio is passing through Ozone Pro. A quick refresher. A correlation meter is used in stereo to ensure that the left and right signals will sum to mono without any cancellation of frequencies. If you've ever heard someone recommend that you check your mix in mono, this is what they're talking about. Maybe you've summed your track to mono and noticed that stuff that's hard panned left and right in the stereo field disappears or is less audible than in stereo. To avoid this, you'll want to make sure this little meter is trending toward positive +1 values, north of the zero crossing. Now there's 4 ways to check the phase correlation of a track or mix: polar sample, polar level, lissajous, and the correlation trace. Once you see a trace dipping below the zero point in red, that's an indication that you might need to rethink your panning structure. To be extra sure, hit the mono button on the bottom right side of the interface and listen for any instruments that disappear or become less punchy and powerful. If the effects of the compressor in the Dynamics module in Ozone Pro are too pronounced or punchy, there's actually a setting called Detection Filter, which will make the compressor's action more smooth and less apparent. First, head to the module and click here to enable this view to adjust the frequency response of the detection circuit. When the detection filter is active, you can access the controls outlined here. Most of the time, your low end in whatever track you're working on will be triggering the compressor, perhaps causing the compressor to behave in a way that sonically you don't like. Pressing solo allows you to hear the signal that the compressor's threshold is reacting to. Now from here, you can use a filter shape like a high pass filter or tilt to ensure that sustained bass elements don't trigger the compressor to work more than you want it to. In fact, the tilt control is similar to the thrust circuit found on API compressors, preserving low frequencies using a high-frequency weighted filter curve. Adjust the amount by clicking and entering a value into the text field to modify the slope of the tilt filter. Now let's get into an example. But before we high pass, note that we have a very muddy sound, lots of pumping, but once we enable the high pass filter, we get a much cleaner sound, less audible pumping, and overall much smoother. Here's before and after. And by the way, You can use this detection filter processing in the Dynamics module and in the Vintage Compressor module. Most people don't realize that Ozone Pro is a referencing powerhouse. And as such, there's actually machine learning built into some of the referencing features. When tracks are initially loaded into the reference panel, handles will appear overlaid on the waveform display. The handles represent the boundaries of predetermined loop points. The loop boundaries are placed based on similar segments detected in the track using machine learning technology. So how does this help you? Well, it saves you time having to search the waveform to find the verse and the chorus, because chances are, Ozone will know where the hooks and verses are and be smart enough to position the loop points there itself with some minor tweaking from you afterwards. There's lots of hidden keyboard shortcuts within Ozone Pro. There's even more in the documentation, but for now, I'll mention a couple that I think will speed up your workflow and help you fine-tune your processing. In the EQ section, for example, you can lock adjustments to the vertical axis. By holding the Shift key when dragging a node left or right, you can lock movements to the horizontal or frequency axis, which allows you to make frequency adjustments without accidentally adjusting the gain. This works the same to alter gain without altering frequency. Just hold Shift and start moving up or down with your mouse. Now you can move gain independent of frequency. To make coarse adjustments to the EQ, hold the Shift key and use the arrow keys to make frequency or gain value adjustments in larger increments. To make very fine adjustments, hold the Command or Control key on Windows when using the arrow keys, up, down, left, right, to make frequency or gain value adjustments in smaller increments. This is really helpful if you really want to dial in your EQ with surgical precision. Oh, and one more tip. You can create a movable filter window which allows you to easily focus on frequencies surrounding the location of the click. To access this Alt Solo Hold feature, hold the Alt or Option key and click anywhere on the frequency spectrum. There's two lesser known but powerful features within the EQ module, extra curves and phase control. The time domain response of IIR, or analog filters, sometimes contributes to the change in the overall sound, and this is most clearly observed in broadband transients, where the smearing of different frequency components through a filter can diffuse the sound, causing it to sound less sharp. By enabling Show Extra Curves in the Options menu under the EQ tab, you'll have way more insight into whether this is happening and whether you need to be more conservative with your EQ moves. Now on to phase control. Using global digital mode, you get additional phase control filters in the EQ. And phase response lets you choose per band what kind of phase adjustment is going to occur. Just open the filter, toggle this little arrow icon, and now you can adjust the phase response of that filter. 0% phase means the selected band will have a linear phase response, and 100% phase means that the band will have a minimum phase response. So why is this helpful? Well, pushing the phase toward 100% can be helpful if you notice unwanted audible pre-ringing in the source audio as a result of your EQ adjustments. As I mentioned earlier, Ozone is a referencing powerhouse, and as such, you also have the hidden ability to impose the reference track spectral information on top of your source audio. Let me show you what I mean. First, make sure you've got a track loaded in the reference panel. To toggle this on, head to the IO options pop-up menu above the IO meters. Now, the reference track spectrum will be displayed in the module spectrum meters alongside the spectrum meter of your current or source track. To remind yourself which is which, just remember that the reference spectrum will be the one that isn't shaded or filled in with gray. The one that's filled in is your source audio. So why is this helpful? This is extremely useful if, say, you want to manually EQ aspects of your input to match your reference, or maybe you just want to see how the reference differs tonally from your source track. And a bonus tip, head to the Options menu, then to Spectrum, and from here, change the default average time to something slower, like 10 seconds. This will slow down the motion of both track spectrums, allowing you to really see the tonal differences between the two. Many people mixing and mastering are concerned with a concept called aliasing, and this is a nasty digital distortion that can sometimes happen when using Exciter or saturation plugins. In fact, if you're really curious about this concept, I'd urge you to go check out Are You Listening, which is our mastering series hosted by iZotope's own education director, Jonathan Weiner. It's season 3, episode 2, where he talks about the subject in depth, but for now, I'll just turn your attention to the Exciter module in Ozone Pro. What many people don't know is that we have a feature called oversampling right here, and you'll want to turn this on to reduce aliasing. That's that distortion I was talking about. On a technical level, oversampling increases the sampling rate of the applied distortion to reduce aliasing. And when you turn this on, it's globally applied to all the bands in the module. Be careful though, as oversampling uses more processing power to increase the quality level of the Exciter module, so keep an eye on your CPU. Ozone Pro's acclaimed IRC, or Intelligent Release Control, technology allows you to boost the level of the signal without sacrificing clarity or dynamics. It's one of the most popular feature sets in Ozone Pro. But did you know that one of the IRCs dates back to the beloved Ozone 5? The IRC III, Pumping Character Style, is the legacy setting, and this is the behavior used in Ozone version 5.01 and earlier. Many people still love the sound of Ozone 5, and that's why this IRC remains in the plugin today. It's a special one that represents the least aggressive style setting for IRC III and doesn't constrain the limiter's release behavior. It can tend toward a slower release behavior, which may result in pumping that might sound good. So give it a shot the next time you're auditioning IRCs with that set tip that I showed you earlier. You might be familiar with Ozone Pro's Master Assistant. That's the AI-powered technology that listens to your audio and then gives you a custom starting point for your master, with some input from you, of course. But did you know that you can also train the Master Assistant to make your track sound like a reference that you love? Let me show you how it works. To get started, head to Master Assistant. Select here to choose any reference track that is currently loaded in the reference panel as your target, or by importing a reference. Now, the target loudness and target EQ curves will be calculated from the loudness and EQ curve of the select reference track. You can still choose modern or vintage. Your choice here will determine if Ozone will use modern EQs, compressors, and limiters to make your track sound like the reference, or if the vintage EQ, compressor, and limiter will be used instead. Next, pick your format, CD or streaming. And now, Master Assistant will get you closer to your reference's tone and loudness. Thank you so much for watching. What's your favorite feature in Ozone? And is there maybe a plugin that we make that you would like to see in a 10 hidden features video in the future? Let us know in the comments. And head to iZotope.com to download a free trial of Ozone Pro. And be sure to check out the Learn section where we have all kinds of free educational content. Thank you so much for watching. Happy mastering and take care.